My name is Joy, also known as Ziggy, and this here is Winston, and welcome to my vlog! Started spray painting our new bench that I bought, and then I realized I was out of spray paint and you need more than one can. So I'm at Target right now getting all my jazz, getting spray paint. I gotta get the curtains. Just gonna, you know, we're just gonna make it work. We're gonna make it work. All right, so I just got back. They didn't have spray paint there, so I still have to go to Lowe's, but I got these blackout curtains. They're green for the outside. Probably not gonna last forever because I don't think these are meant to go outside, but you know what? Could be worse. Still blackout, and they were like really cheap, so I'm okay if they, you know, wear out. All right, so I just finished at Lowe's. Got my thing. Let's do this. I'm ready to have a green rocking bench, okay?
So this is what I have already kind of started on. I don't think it's gonna need to be perfect, but we got string lights happening. And then, pretty soon here, we're gonna have the curtains going across there. So yeah, I'm pretty pumped. So we're gonna do our first layer and then kind of go from there, or first other layer.
So if you don't have a mask for spray painting, something else you can do is take a shirt, put your head through, so you can see your eyes, and then you find the sleeves, and then you make a ninja thing out of it, and then you just find the sleeves. And you are set to do some spray painting.
All right, so we got a lot of it done so far. It wasn't quite long enough here, but you know what, it's fine. Then we have our bench that I already painted. I just have to flip over these and then do these. And then we just put it together. News on the curtains though, they're green, but then the other side's white. But you know what, sometimes you gotta make the most of it.
So I just have to get a light bulb adapter to plug in these lights. Then we have our shades. Then we have the bench that I just finished. It actually came out really cute. Pretty proud of it.
Definitely didn't take me 2 days to do this.
It did! We gotta get like a table out here. We gotta get some more stuff.
One of my highlights from this week was doing my amazing friend Kaya's hair. We took her from just like this brown natural color to this emerald green freaking ombre. It was so cool.
Making a strawberry jam. And how you do that is you just cut up some strawberries. You start to just boil it down on like a medium heat or so. Nothing too crazy because you don't want it to start to scorch or anything. I like to use a wooden spoon because it works on nonstick. This one's got a face. Then you're just gonna add a little bit of pectin in there and some sugar.
Just making some strawberries.
starts to smell a little interesting. Kind of like when you leave strawberries in water for a while and they kind of smell a little different. Not like fresh strawberries, but still not bad. Right now they're kind of starting to sweat a little bit.
Don't be afraid to just kind of take your time. I like to pull up a stool, eat some cake. You know, the usual. All right, so it's starting to come together. I've done a few things I'm going to show you here in just a minute already myself. But what you want to do is you want to start to, sorry, the lighting's kind of crappy. You want to start to kind of tap the bottom. You don't want to do this too like hard or anything, because obviously you don't want hot sugar coming up on you. Just very gentle tapping. Nothing crazy. Sometimes I even push it up against the side, squeeze it up against the side, and it kind of breaks them apart even more. It's weird with this smiley face spoon, but yeah, we're just trying to break apart the big chunks of strawberry right now. Alright, so now this is kind of looking like this. This is a pretty good consistency. You want to make sure nothing's stuck to the bottom because you don't want anything to scorch, obviously. Tap off your spoon. It's good to have something actually under there, but I don't. But I remember normally per like 4 cups, you usually use about 1 cup of sugar. I feel like that's a lot, and I don't feel like I have 4 cups, but I didn't add. So I'm just going to add about 1/2 cup. I'm sure some of you might be watching this and cringing. A little bit less than 1/2 cup. There we go.
You might not.
Now I'm going to add, I don't have lemon juice, so I'm going to be adding a little bit of lime juice. Sometimes you just got to make do. Then I'm just going to add a little bit. Yeah. So this helps to preserve it. For 1 cup of sugar, you want to add 1 tablespoon of pectin. Got some nice picks. So, these are these really cute freaking measuring spoons I got for Isaiah when I was in Salem. They're so cute. They're a little kitty. Ooh, and then there's a kitten! Since we only did 1/2 cup of sugar, I almost just forgot. You want to kind of bring it to be about 1/2. Alright, so you guys can see it's thickening up a lot, which is good. You guys, it's starting to look like jam. So I'm taking off the heat now, just letting it kind of thicken up and bubble up a little bit longer. Cool down just a bit, and then I'm gonna put it in the Tupperware. So what are your guys' like favorite desserts? Or just like things to make as a dessert for food? Cause I personally, I don't know why, but I've been loving making macarons. Like, they're so good. So I'm actually going to be using this jam for macarons once I like get the time, because they take a long time, unfortunately. So we're gonna get there. So with pectin, you actually use 1 tablespoon per every 4 cups of fruit. So I had about 2 cups, that's why I'm only using that much. There we go. The more you know. So now that it's starting to cool down a little bit, don't look at that nail, it's broken. I just got a little Tupperware. I don't want to use anything that big. Plus, this is like the perfect size for it. Pop this bad boy into the fridge. And I'm just gonna let that chill out in there until I'm ready to make the macarons. So I'm thinking like maybe tomorrow or the next day. Or the next day we'll play by ear. So we just got some plants and we got this super cute little bonsai plant. That says to dream. And the cool thing about bonsai plants is they literally look like little mini trees.
All right, you guys. So I'm gonna try to show you how to fold a fitted sheath. It's probably not gonna go super well because I don't really know super well myself, but we're gonna try it together. So to my knowledge, I like to take each corner rather than trying to go from like the folds. So here's two corners. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lay them out this way and let the sheet just kind of fold in. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this and this corner and I'm gonna fold it into thirds. Get it into thirds. I'm gonna fold it over. This is where you could either just fold it like normal, or what I personally like to do is I fold it into thirds again. And then you got a nice little rectangle of sheets.
So I made this vegan freaking cauliflower bites with this vegan buffalo sauce. I will post a link to this recipe in the description. Another really fun thing that happened is I went to the Gilbert Feastival Food Truck Festival with my amazing friend Heather.
Got it. Hi.
Basket for me because it's our first Easter together, like in an apartment of our own. So, Amanda doesn't know it, but we have a surprise party for her. And to kind of waste the time, I took her to this place, and it's actually really cute. She has no idea. We flew in all our friends from Oklahoma. Amanda's looking at some candles. Ooh, what is that?
That's apple spice.
Oh my god, that looks amazing. Now we're in sweet brew coffee for Amanda's birthday after day. Woo! Found her new nook. Like literally in the corner of the entire establishment. I'm spending time with you, spending time with Seriously, wait, ring the doorbell. It's rude to freaking just let yourself in.
Hello!
you can be my guiding light. Keep me company in the night. That's all I need, all I want is for you to stay a little longer now. With arms around me like a border, like the air I breathe, I let you in. Keep me warm underneath my skin, 'cause I
party of his own. Oh yeah, it was messy.
Like an endless stream, you take me in to a place that I never been. Now I'm giving in to your touch.
Our fridge is mostly alcohol right now. Happy birthday! Eat your noodles. Did y'all want
an avocado?
So I'm making a vegan butter garlic salt, like sauce, and then some artichokes. Tuning in to my very first vlog. I'm gonna try to be documenting every week, kind of summing it up on like a Monday, figuring it out from there. But I'm starting this because I'm actually getting Corgi puppies like in a couple months. Like we get to choose them in 5 weeks about. And I really want to document their lives. So thank you guys for hanging out. And that is a week in the life of me. Bye, you guys.
I will see you guys next week.